Hi, I'm Mark Edwards. Welcome to Anaheim Stadium for the 1987 Supercross kickoff. It was almost 4 years ago to this very day that a young man from Axon, Virginia won his very first professional race. That win sparked the beginning of a career that redefined the term champion. The fact that David Bailey won't be here on the line this Saturday night is the reason we're making this video. I've known David now for nearly 6 years. We've become very good friends. I'd like David to know that I'm thinking about him, wishing him well, and a lot of other people are thinking of him also. Right now, let's go to some of his friends and fellow racers, see what their comments are about David Bailey, the racer, and David Bailey, the person. What is it about David Bailey's riding style that set him apart from all the other riders?
I think style.
He's always very smooth and very perfect.
Smooth riding style.
A lot of confidence in himself and his riding ability.
Well, he's just got a really smooth style, and he's, I guess you'd just consider him the master motocross.
He was fast, consistent, and really good.
Technique.
Smooth, accurate. He knows exactly what he's doing.
Smooth and so very coordinated about it.
Total determination, aggressiveness, and cooperation.
Style.
I think when he's on, I don't think no one can beat him.
Precise.
Consistency, and he's fairly conservative.
David was just an all-around great rider.
The will and the desire to be the best, which he has been.
His smoothness, his proficiency, his ability to balance the bike.
The most difficult track would be the best for him because he was so good.
Competitor.
His attitude, he's determined, and he really has a will to win.
David is the smoothest rider I've ever seen.
His smooth riding ability.
David's riding style is smoother than the other riders.
Well, he's obviously very smooth.
He's one of the smoothest in the world.
Smooth and relaxed.
I'd say he's probably the smoothest rider in the world.
David was just very calculated.
It's just so smooth and accurate and precise.
His technique.
Smooth and controlled.
Smooth, fast, stylish, surgeon. Perfect.
Fluid, smooth, technical.
Calculating, smooth, consistent, strong. He just flows.
Smoothness is the whole key.
Technically precise.
Very precise.
Just very graceful.
Smooth and consistent.
Being able to control the bike as well as he does.
He was totally smooth.
I think his style is smooth, consistent, never out of control.
I would expect that those front runners, David Bailey, rider number 6 with a lead, Jeff Ward, rider number 4, running in that number 2 position, and rider number 5, Rick Johnson, running in third, will leave the rest of the pack way behind. Bailey takes the green flag, and lap number 1 is put into the record book.
He's a much better rider than the others for technology.
Technical and loose.
He's a perfectionist.
Consistency.
and class.
Oh, he's very smooth and very aggressive.
Oh, yeah, he's eye-catchy.
If there's one rider to copy, it's David on his riding style. He's the best.
Perfect. Smooth, and I think there's nobody else out there like him.
Probably technically the most efficient rider in the world.
His timing, his precision in his riding.
Who's the best motocross rider ever in the history of the world?
Cousin Dave.
It wasn't so long ago you were a dreamer. That you'd be number one. Well, I'm one man that you made a believer. It feels so good to see all the things you've done. Hard work and determination, that's the way you play. For all the world to see.
Thank you.
Born December 31st, 1961, David Bailey showed an early interest in anything that had wheels. At age 10, David began to ride motorcycles. Starting on Yamaha Mini Enduros, David eventually graduated to the earth-shaking, state-of-the-art 100cc Bultacos. Of course, in 1972, state-of-the-art meant about 12 horsepower, 4 inches of suspension, and a shift lever on the right-hand side of the bike. Under the guidance of Father Gary, a renowned motocross instructor, David was soon winning many of the amateur races he entered. In 1978, David took his 250cc motorcycle to the Amateur National Championships and came away with the win. This was to be the last title ever won on the Bultaco. In 1979, David turned pro, riding number 333 in the majority of the national 250cc events. He earned a very respectable number 93 national ranking. David then went on to contest the Trans-USA Series, winning the 250cc support class. The following year, riding the number 45 Kawasaki, David showed consistency and style, turning in some very respectable showings and earning a final national ranking for the coming year of number 23. During the off-season prior to 1982, David fielded offers from various teams to ride their machines. When the call came from five-time world champion Roger DeCoster, now working for American Honda, David's decision was made. DeCoster had recognized the makings of a future champion and personally recommended that David be selected to ride the factory Hondas. The rest, as they say, is history. There were some changes in store for David in 1983. He was recognized by JT Racing Apparel and signed an exclusive contract with them to represent them at all the national events. Over the next 5 years, David Bailey proved that Roger DeCoster knew what he was talking about. His first ever pro win was the kickoff of the 83 Supercross season at Anaheim Stadium in Anaheim, California. David also won the Washington, D.C. Supercross, where unbelievably, he rode the last half of the race with a broken foot. His final win of the Supercross season was at Foxborough, Massachusetts, giving him a 10-point lead in the Supercross series. David took that 10-point lead to Pasadena, California in the Rose Bowl, where he could only manage a 6th-place finish. But that 6th-place finish was all David needed to be the 1983 Supercross champion. Outdoors, David was just as tough. Again, he won 3 events, starting with the Gainesville, Florida 250 National.
Guys, David Bailey's first ever national win. How about a big round of applause for David? Congratulations, Dave.
He continued his winning ways in Buchanan, Michigan, and went on to wrap up the 250 National title in Castle Rock, Colorado. The combination of these two titles also gave David the distinction of being named the first Grand National Champion in United States motocross history. Oh. 1983 also saw David win two Grand Prix events. His first was the United States Grand Prix for 250cc machines at Unadilla, New York. Overcoming fatigue and extreme stomach cramps, David posted a 1-2 moto score for the overall victory. His second Grand Prix win was a half a world away at Osaka, Japan. Racing before the Honda factory VIPs, David showed why he was America's number one racer. David capped off his 83 season by being named the American Motorcycle Association Rider of the Year and by being voted Motocross Action Magazine Rider of the Year by motocross fans worldwide. So it's no wonder that with sponsors like American Honda, JT Racing, Scott Goggles, and Dunlop Tires, that David had such a successful 1983 season. In 1984, David dominated the 500cc Nationals like no one before him. Winning an amazing 16 of the 20 motos on the schedule, David took an early points lead and never looked back. Starting with the opener in Gainesville, Florida, the little professor went on a hot streak. When it was over, he had strung together wins in Orange, California, Sacramento, California, Atlanta, Georgia, Mount Morris, Pennsylvania, Buchanan, Michigan, Binghamton, New York, and Millville, Minnesota. America had a new 500cc national champion. David had some problems in 1983 at the Daytona Supercross, starting with a first turn crash in his heat. But riding like a true champion, David came from behind to win his heat race. In 1984, however, it was not just a heat win, but the overall victory, winning him the richest purse in American Supercross. David also won Supercross events in Houston, Texas, Foxborough, Massachusetts, Sacramento, California, and even Paris, France. Again, in 84, just as in 83, David went to Japan for the Japanese Grand Prix and came home a winner. With this incredible year of racing in the record books, the French magazine Moto Review rated David Bailey the number one motocross racer in the world. In 1985, David, again riding the 500s, was the overall winner at four events. His smooth, calculated riding style and strict training program enabled him to take the wins in Las Vegas, Nevada, Mount Morris, Pennsylvania, Atlanta, Georgia, and Millville, Minnesota. Another big win came on the night of May 11th in the Los Angeles Coliseum. On that night, David walked away with top honors and the coveted first-place trophy from the Super Bowl of Motocross. Later that year, David returned to California and put together back-to-back moto wins to destroy the world's top 500cc riders at the United States Grand Prix at Carlsbad Raceway.
Hi, David Bailey, winner of the United States Grand Prix here at Carlsbad.
During the 5 years that David rode for American Honda, David was proud to represent his country as a member of the United States team at the Motocross and Trophy des Nations. At this event, the U.S. team has been dominant since 1981. David has been fortunate enough to be a member of this winning team since 1982. Not only have we won these events 5 years running, but in 1986, the American team made history by posting a perfect score, an accomplishment which may never be equaled. As I sit here and reflect on David Bailey's incredible racing career, I wonder what more can be said of his amazing drive, his determination, and his absolute will to be the best. With that in mind, let me sum up David's 1986 accomplishments in this manner. David again won the 500cc National Championship, scoring overall wins in three of the six events. He finished second overall in both the Supercross and 250 National Series, winning four Supercrosses along the way. In Europe, David won the Paris Supercross and every moto of both Italian Supercrosses. While in Italy, David entered and won his first ever Superbiker race, and in doing so, set a new course record. What, then, has David Bailey accomplished? How about 12 U.S. Supercross victories, 18 national wins, 2 World Championship Grand Prix wins, 18 World Championships, and 6 national titles? Truly, one of the most successful racing careers ever. Here's to you, Dave.
Hi, this is David Bailey, the 1983 Supercross champion. People say I'm Smooth.
Oh, it's very smooth.
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 Smooth. Smooth.
I'm the only Supercross champion to have ever won the Grand National title. In fact, I'm so smooth I've won it twice. I'm the smoothest rider on the circuit.
Tell us a little bit about David Bailey as a person.
David, it's been our experience from JT Racing that over the years has been one of the most cooperative riders that we've ever had the pleasure and opportunity of working with, bar none.
Awesome.
I love David. He's one of the riders that come into our place when we work with riders, and we've worked with almost all the riders over the years since the beginning with Joel Robert. And David is like an old friend walking through the door. He's not a prima donna. He's not an egotistical person. He's a real, genuine person. And that, I think, is part of his secret to being so successful.
Personally, he's a neat guy. He's had class. He's intelligent. He was always one hell of a racer and always willing to talk to the press. Incredible human being.
Oh, he's great. I've known David for a long time. And he's just a great person. I loved working with him, and just wish I still could, that's all.
Oh, well, a long time ago, he looked up to me, and then in the 5 years I turned around, I kind of looked up to him because he's the best.
When David first started riding with you, Bob, on Team Honda, you seemed to help David out quite a bit in the beginning of his career, which you didn't do with a lot of other riders. Why was that?
Oh, mainly, like we were talking about earlier, is I liked them. A lot of riders have cocky attitudes when they get the factory ride. They think they're the big time, they know everything, and David always wanted to learn. He wasn't at the big time. He had the factory ride, but he didn't act like he had the big head, and I wanted to see him do good. And it was a matter of time. When we were both on Honda, the first year I did pretty good, and I could beat him a lot of times, but after the first year, I saw a lot of his tail.